Good day, children. Have a pleasant morning. I hope that you are very safe in your home. Today's topic is transformational sentence, class 12 and 11th also. Just make a look on that. Transformational sentences, classified into three types: simple, complex, and compound sentences. Before entering into transformational sentence, how to transfer the sentence, we have to just look on this. Introduction of simple sentence and complex sentence and compound sentence. Look at the board now. Simple sentence that contains only one independent clauses. That means the sentence which contains a subject and predicate and is expresses a full thought. It expresses the full sense of the sentence. We call it as simple sentence. For example, Raju reads newspaper. Here, Raju subject, reads verb, and newspaper is an object, right? So it will make a subject and predicate. A sentence which has subject and predicate, we call as simple sentence. It makes it very simple. Ron is running. So Raju reads newspaper. Just take a next example. The boys went to the park. The boys went to the park. See here, the boys went to the park is a simple sentence. See, the boys, subject, verb and object. Here, subject and predicate. The sentence which has subject and predicate, it makes a sense of the full sentence. We will call it a simple sentence. Understand? See, sentence that has one independent class, that is called a simple sentence. We'll move on to complex sentence now. Contains one main class and one or more subordinate class. It contains only one main class and one or more subordinate class. We'll make some example like goods train. Have you seen about goods train? Head part and lot of box are which is attached there, right? It's a better example for the complex sentence. So one main class we compare to the goods head of the train and other remaining boys which is attached to the goods train, we call as subordinate class here. You think like this. We keep the example like this. You can remember easily here. So contains one main class and one or more subordinate class. For example, though he is poor, he is happy. He is happy. It gives a full sense of meaning. Though he is poor, it's a subordinate conjunction. We call this subordinate conjunction. In other words, we can say it contains an independent class and a dependent class. See, the complex sentence which contains an independent class as well as a dependent class. Here, dependent class begins with subordinate conjunction. So, dependent class begins with subordinate conjunction. Subordinate conjunction is nothing but although, after, even though. Just take a look on here. After, although, because, before, however, if, since, so that, unless, while, whenever, when, etc. So, dependent class begins with subordinate class. Simply, we can say complex sentence is a dependent class. And simple sentence is a main class, principal class, or independent class, because it gives a full sentence in a single way. But here, in complex sentence, it makes somewhat, they have to divide. This sentence has to depend on other sentence to give the full sense of meaning. Understand? I'm going fast. So, we'll make it little bit slower now. See, simple sentence is nothing but is an independent class. It gives a full sense of meaning. Complex sentence is nothing but it's a dependent class. This sentence have depend with other sentence give this full sense of meaning, full thought. Understood? So let's look this example now. Here, because it's called as subordinate conjunctions, there are more than 7 subordinate conjunctions. Main subordinate conjunctions are there. As like main and much more subordinate conjunctions are here on the board. After, although, because, before, however, if, since, so that, unless, while, and whenever, etc. Like lot of subordinate conjunctions are there. Go through the books also. Here, the dependent class, because so subordinate conjunction always, I already told to you that subordinate class, that is independent class, always begins in the first, comes in the first of the sentence. See here, because the subordinate conjunction, because the word is subordinate conjunction. Let's see now, because the boys went to the park, they did not go to the zoo. Understand? Because the boys went to the park, they did not go to the zoo. Have you understood? Let's move on to next one. Next one is compound sentence. It's nothing but contains two independent classes joined by a coordinating conjunction. See, there are seven types of coordinating conjunctions are there. See here, contains two independent classes joined by a coordinating conjunctions. For example, she is smart and she knows it. How we have to take a like example? A simply example is an apartment. See, each floor are connected by some particles, right? Here, the sentence, the two main clause connected by the coordinate conjunction is called as compound sentence. Understand? The coordinate conjunction like but, yet, still, nor, and, so, these are called as coordinating conjunctions. These conjunctions connecting two main clause, we call it as compound sentence. This conjunction connecting two main clause, we call it as compound sentence. For example, she is smart, she knows it. See, and we call it as coordinating conjunction. And the word and we call it as coordinating conjunction here, even though but, yet, still, not, we call as coordinating conjunction. Some types of coordinating conjunctions are there. See the another one example. The boys went to the park. So one main clause. The boys went to the park and coordinate conjunction is that they did not go to the zoo. See, two main clauses connected with but. That means coordinate conjunction. We call this compound sentence. Understand? So we call this complex, simple sentence, complex and compound sentence are three types of sentences which makes a transformative sentence. See, simple is nothing but it's a dependent independent class. Complex is independent class. Compound, coordinate conjunction, which is to connect two main classes. See here, this is a main class and this one is subordinate class in complex sentence. This is a main class and this one is main class, which connected with and coordinate conjunction. See, it gives a simple sentence. It gives or it expresses a full thought. It expresses the full thought of the sentence. We call it as simple sentence. It contains subject and predicate also. Have you understood? So let's take example for subordinate conjunctions are there, and then coordinate conjunctions are. See, we have to make a difference. What are all the subordinate conjunctions? What are all the coordinating conjunctions? See, subordinate conjunctions are there many. After, although, because, before, however, since, it comes in the front, at the first of the sentence. Okay, we have to put in the first of the sentence. See here, coordinating conjunctions are seven. We have to fix it in the middle. That's the difference here. இதை நீங்கள் ஃபஸ்ட்டில் தான் நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம், சென்டென்ஸ் கூட ஃபஸ்ட்டில் யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம், இன்றைக்கி சென்டென்ஸ் கூட மிடில் யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம். ஓகே, ஜஸ்ட் மேக் எ டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் ஆஃப் கோஆர்டினேட்டிங் அண்ட் சப் கோஆர்டினேட்டிங் கன்ஜெக்ஷன்ஸ், சப்ஆர்டினேட் கன்ஜெக்ஷன்ஸ். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? ஸோ ச மெயின் கிளாஸ் அண்ட் சப்ஆர்டினேட் கிளாஸ். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? ஸோ நவ் வில் சீ த ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபார்மேஷன், ஹவு தி சென்டென்ஸ் ஆர் ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபர்ட் இன் டு simple to complex, complex to compound, and simple to compound, likewise, vice versa. Okay? So, see type 1 here, I'll just write the keywords for the type 1. See, type 1 is nothing but for your clarification, for your understanding, I just written type 1, type 2, type 3 like that, for your better understanding. Look at here, type 1. On plus present participle. Here, the present participle nothing but verb plus ing. We call it as present participle. On plus present participle. Here, present participle is nothing but verb plus ing. And look at the compound sentence. And immediately, we have to use in the middle of the sentences. Then, complex as soon as. So, now, we are going to change into simple, compound, complex with this example in the type 1. See here, the child saw his mother, he ran towards her. I repeat the question now. The child saw his mother, he ran towards her. Now we are going to change into simple sentence now. Now we are going to change into simple sentence. See, on plus present participle. Present participle is nothing but the verb plus ing. For example, run, running. See here in this sentence, for the first main class, the verb is saw. The verb saw. Now the verb saw transformed into see, it's a present participle. Present participle make this seeing. Make it as seeing. Have you understood? Shall we convert the sentence now? Okay, tell me now. On seeing his mother, on seeing his mother, he ran towards her. Understand? Successfully we converted, right? On seeing his mother, he ran towards her. Look at the question and then sentence type, the first type into simple sentence now. Nothing but simple, we don't want to care about that. It's very, very simple. Make key points as in your memory. We can do it very easily. Okay? Probably, don't think how you have to keep all the key points. See, if you go with as much examples, it's very easy to remember. Understand? See, on plus present possible, right? Nothing but present possible, nothing but I already insist to you that verb plus ing. Here the verb is saw. So we have to change in the present tense. The saw changes see, present, and add ing here, it makes present participle. So as per our key points, as per our rule, we have to change like on seeing his mother, he ran towards her. I hope that you are understand. Shall see the compound sentence now. Shall see compound now. And immediately. See, I already told that the compound is nothing but yes, conjunction which connected two main classes. Right? See here. The child saw his mother. The child saw his mother. What you have to write here? And immediately. And immediately. See here, it's like coordinate conjunction. He ran towards her. See here, the two main classes. See, the child saw his mother, main class. He ran towards her, main class, which is connected by and immediately. Understood? See here, the child saw his mother. The child saw his mother, and immediately is under compound word, the keyword. You have to insert that and immediately, and he ran towards her. See, the two main class were connected by the conjunctions. Understand? Let's see compound sentence now. Sorry, complex sentence now. Complex. Use as soon as now. As soon as the child saw his mother. As soon as the child saw his mother, he ran towards her. Understand? See, I already insisted or already told to you that subordinate conjunctions we have to use in the first. Simply we can say complex sentence, a word we can use it in the first, just write it, you can cut out with the answer now. See, the child saw his mother, he ran towards her. We have to change into complex here. As soon as the child saw his mother, he ran towards her. He ran towards her. Understand? Just make a look on this and make a key point also with your note or some others. See, it's very important here. The key point is very, very important. If you keep remember this key point, you can easily convert what of the sentence they given. What type of the sentence, don't worry, you can do with the help of these key points. Understand? Let's see the second type. Here, type 2 here, due to an account of owing to, compound and so, and then as, since, because. You can use as, since, because in complex. Let's take a look on the example here. It was raining heavily, the match was cancelled. Due to heavy rain, the match was cancelled. We can use it due to easily here. Let's go for the rule now. So, let's take on account of here. On account of heavy rain. On account of heavy rain, the match was cancelled. Understand? This I took on account of, just you can do as due to, owing to also. See, due to heavy rain, instead of on account of, you can use it due to here. Due to heavy rain, the match was cancelled. Owing to heavy rain, the match was cancelled. You can use these three words, it's not a problem. Sorry, it's a three phrases, it's not a problem. You can use it as your wish. But here you have to see, okay, it's a present participle here, then I change this a verb here. You have to make alterations here. Understand? Okay, let's look on the compound sentence now. Let's take a look to compound. So and so. It's very easy. It was raining heavily. It was raining heavily. See here, so and so. We can use either so or and so. So the match was cancelled. See, past present tense here. Okay, past present continuous tense, which changes heavy rain here. Okay, see here, it was raining heavily, so the match was cancelled. Understand? Just I used here so here, you can use and so also here. That's not a problem. Okay, then we'll see complex sentence now. We have to change into complex. As, since, because, I just ask now. As it was rain heavily. As it was rain heavily, the match was stopped. Match was cancelled or stopped. Understand? We'll make as it rained heavily without any tenses. We'll make it as it rained heavily, the match was cancelled. As it was raining heavily, the match was cancelled. You can write as you wish, no problem. In some other way also. As it rained heavily, the match was cancelled. As it was raining heavily, the match was cancelled. Understand? You can write both the ways. We get the correct answer. See the second type now. Type 2, due to, on account of, on owing to, so on and so, and as, since, because. Look at the example. It was raining heavily, the match was cancelled. Simple sentence, an account of heavy rain, the match was cancelled due to heavy rain, the match was cancelled. Even owing to heavy rain, match was cancelled. Compound sentence, it was raining heavily, so the match was cancelled. Then complex.
Let's see the third type here. Type 3, in simple, compound and complex. In simple, we get in spite of, despite, compound, but and still, and complex, though, although, even though. We have to change the sentence into these three types now. See here, example. He is poor, he is generous. He is poor, he is generous. Let's start with simple here. We have changed the simple sentence. In spite of. Use in spite of here. In spite of his poor, in other form it known as poverty, right? In spite of his poverty, he is, in spite of his poverty, he is generous. He is generous. You can write in other form also. In spite of his being poor. See, we can write it in the two ways. In spite of his poverty, he is generous. In spite of, that means in spite of, in spite of his being, see here the present tense, we can use his being poor. Okay, actually it is in present tense, we can use it. His being here, we can write in two forms and we get in spite of his poverty, he is generous. Otherwise, in spite of his being poor, he is generous. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, see compound sentence here. Let's change it to compound sentence. We have used but and still. He is poor, but he is generous. He is poor, yet he is generous. See, he is poor. He is poor, but he is generous. See, here but is quality of conditions. Okay, so can we say that two main words, you have kind of the quality conjunction, but. So, successfully change like this, compound sentence. Let's move to complex sentence here. Complex. Though, although, even though. Shall we change here? He is poor, he is generous. Although, he is poor, he is generous. Even though, he is poor, he is generous. Though, he is poor, he is generous. See? Though, he is poor, he is generous. Understood. See, if you give it, if the sentence is given in spite of, see, you have to understand the keyword in spite. You have to change it to compound. Immediately, your mind should be in compound. The word of but and still. If they give the word like but and still as a compound sentence, as you have to change it to complex or simple, instead of your mind has to go that way, in spite of all the universe. See, you have to remember, you have to keep present in your mind like keywords of this type. Not only this type, for all the type, you have to keep remember this kind of keywords is very useful for change the three types of sentences. Understand? See, if they given, the question paper is given like though, ask you to change into compound, ask you. Though is poor, is generous, like that, is given. You have to change, you ask you to change like simple or compound, you get your mind fixed here, like button still and in spite of this type. Understand? Let's move on to type 4. Two, very and so, and so. Next type. It's very easy. See, this one, and this one, and this type. These types are very important because often they are seen in question paper. Okay? Let's see here. The boss is heavy, I cannot lift it. First of all, you have to change into simple sentence here. Simple sentence here. The box is too heavy to lift it. Understand? The box is
The box is 2 kb, 2 lift it.
Understand? The box is 2 kb,
2 lift it. And next, into compound sentence here. They use very and also. Okay? So, compound sentence. How you have to change the compound sentence? The box is heavy, I cannot lift it. Okay? The box is very heavy and so I cannot lift it. Understand? So, the box is very heavy and so I cannot lift it. Understand? The box is very heavy and so I cannot lift it by using compound sentence. Let's move on to complex sentence now. Take a look on that. So that. See here. See here. The box is heavy, I cannot lift it. See, the box is so heavy. The box is so heavy. What are heavy? That I cannot lift it. It's very easy if you remember the keywords. Which one is comes under simple, compound, complex. If you remember these keywords, very, very easy to convert the sentence into simple, compound, and complex, whatever it is. Understand? See here, the box is heavy, I cannot lift it. Is the question. Now change into simple sentence. The box is too heavy to lift it. If the question paper, if they ask me a question like this, the box is too heavy to lift it, change into compound sentence. Then immediately your mind has to fix with very and also. So I keep on telling you have to keep remember these keywords is very useful for your examination to get 2 marks easily, in easy way. If they given in the compound sentence, if they given a compound sentence, they ask them you to change it to complex or simple sentence like vice versa. The box is so heavy that I cannot lift it. It's a complex sentence. They ask to change into simple sentence. Understand? Have you understood? Okay. Then we'll see the type 5. Next, we are going to see the type 5. I already insisted you that type 1, type 2, these types and all, which I have given for your better understanding. Okay. In the event of, in case of, or else, otherwise, if, unless class. See, if and unless. So 2 mark. It's a separate question they will ask. Understood? See, it's very important. Look at the example. He must see the teacher. He must see the teacher. He can get his doubts clear. He can get his doubts clear. Understand? He must see the teacher. He can get his doubts clear. Let's move on to simple sentence here. In event of. See, we can use it like present. Perfect tense here. Even there also you can use it present perfect tense here. In the event of seeing the teacher he can get his doubts clear. Understood? In the event of seeing the teacher, he can get his doubts clear. Understood? Let's go on to next now. Compound sentence. Or else, other. You can use or else or otherwise. Okay? See him. He must see the teacher
just I take otherwise. Otherwise, he cannot, because see here, otherwise he cannot get his doubts clear. Otherwise, he cannot get his doubts clear. Understand?
Let's move on to if and unless class. We'll make it complex sentence. Comes under complex sentence. If class,
we'll make it complex here. If he see the teacher,
it's a present tense. We'll make it if class as a present tense. Unless class, like
if he must see the teacher. He must see the teacher. It's a present tense, so we can use it can here. Okay, he can get his doubts clear. He can get his doubts clear. Understand?
See, we'll make it unless class right here.
Unless, you can use unless
he must see the teacher.
He could not get his doubt clear.
Understand? That's a very, very important type. Keep remember, as much questions from this type. They're asking continuously as much questions from this type 5, 4 and 3. Understand? Let's move on to the next one. Type 6. See here. In simple, besides nothing but in addition to. Besides nothing but in addition. In addition, okay. Then in compound, not only but also. And complex, who. This is also very important type. This is also very important type. Even last year also they asked this question often there. In the question paper. So these four types are very, very important. Keep on practicing in your home. You can get good marks in transformation sentence here. Okay, let's move on to example. Ronnie is a singer. Ronnie is a teacher. Ronnie is a singer. Ronnie is a teacher. Let's convert it to simple sentence now. Besides, is present tense, we can use it being. Besides being a singer, Ronnie is a teacher. Understand? Ronnie is a teacher. Then compound sentence. Ronnie is not only a singer, but also a teacher. Understood? Ronnie is not only a singer but also a teacher. Then come on to the complex sentence. We change it to complex. Look at the rule. Who? Ronnie, who is a singer. Ronnie, who is a singer, is also a teacher. Understand? So Ronnie is not only a singer but also a teacher. It's like in compound sentence, we made complex sentence. Ronnie, who is a singer, is also a teacher. This comes under complex sentence. Okay. Let's see the next type here. Type 7. 2 plus verb in compound and so and complex so that. See, let's take a look on this example. He worked hard, he gets straight rank. He work hard, he get straighter. Now change the simple sentence here. He worked hard.
He worked hard to, what's the verb here?
Get.
To get state rank.
Understand? See, 2 plus verb. Here,
2 plus verb.
It's a simpler way. It's a very, very simple. See, he worked hard to get. Here, verb in the sentence, the verb is get. He worked hard to get state rank. Okay, so see the compound here.
Compound sentence.
You have to use and so. He worked hard.
He worked hard. And so.
See here. He worked hard. And so he got good marks.
He got straight rank. He got straight rank.
Understand? நல்ல மார்க் வாங்கிட்டாங்க ஸ்டேட் ரேங்க் வாங்கிட்டான் சொல்றோம் அதாங்க சொல்றோம் ஹி ஒர்க் ஹார்ட் அண்ட் சோ ஹி காட் ஸ்டேட் ரேங்க் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் லெட்ஸ் கோ ஃபார் தி காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் சென்டென்ஸ் ஹியர் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் சென்டென்ஸ் ஹி ஒர்க் ஹார்ட் ஹி கெட் ஸ்டேட் ரேங்க் யூ ஆர் யூஸ் சோ தட் ஹியர் ஹி ஒர்க் ஹார்ட்
ஹி ஒர்க் ஹார்ட் சோ தட் ஹி
could, you are use could here,
so that he could get state rank. Understand?
See, you are to use could here. Okay, so take a look on this 2 plus verb and so that he worked hard and get state rank. We changed into 3 kinds of sentence here, 3 types of sentence here. Take a look on this. Then see, type number 8, it's very important. Having plus past participle, PP is nothing but past participle. After plus present participle, and then, and after subject had past participle. Okay, it's not a keyword or rule to frame the sentence in a proper way. Take an example here. Take a look on this example. He finished his work, he retired. How you have to change into simple compound complex. Let's see now. Having, we have to use first having here.
Simple. Having.
See, past participle. See, it's already, the word which is past participle only. Okay, you can use it directly here.
Having finished his work, he retired. Understand?
Because the verb which is already present as a past participle, we can take it directly. Let's go with after here.
After
plus present participle. See, present participle nothing but verb plus ing. I already told to you, present participle is nothing but verb plus ing. Okay?
Finishing his work, he retired.
Okay, understand? Let's see the compound sentence here. You have to use and then or and.
He finished his work.
He, you have to use
and then, okay. And then he retired.
Understand? See, he finished his work and then he retired. He finished his work and he retired. You can use and or and then here. Next, we'll go with complex sentence here.
Complex.
You have to use after plus subject plus had plus past participle. After plus subject plus had plus past participle. Here we have to use after. You may wonder that here also we have to use after and there also we have to after. See, here we have to use in the subject part. See, subordinate class is done after use for here, but there we are using at the first, the subject, the phrases like that. Okay, but here after I use the first, but here we can make a subordinate classes also. Okay, so after he subject, after he had finished, after he had finished his work, he retired. Understood? After he had finished, I just told as per our rule, after plus subject plus had plus past participle. Understand? Let's see the next one. Type 9. Quality words and who, where and which. Okay, so see, look at the example. The self ghee is pure. We change into here a simpler way, simple sentence. The self ghee is pure. They sell pure ghee. It gives a full meaning. Okay, a full ghee, full thought. Express a full thought. They sell pure ghee. Change it now. Make it on compound here. We have to use and here. They sell ghee and it is pure. Understand? It is pure. Then we have to make it as a complex sentence here. Complex. They sell ghee, it's pure. They sell ghee, it's pure. Make it complex by using this who, where, or which. Okay? They sell ghee, which it's pure. Understand? Okay, that's all today. We'll meet our next video with a great topic. Thanks for watching. Thank you all.